To configure translation rules, begin by selecting Consolidation from the application cluster. Select Consolidation Process, Translated, and then Translation Overrides. Click Manage Defaults to view or modify the default translation settings. When you first create an application, the system creates default translation settings for Balance Account and Flow Account. For Balance Account, the default translation method is periodic and the rate account is ending. For Flow Account, the default translation method is periodic and the rate account is average. For more information, please view the video tutorial Configuring Translation Settings. You can create translation rules to override the default translation settings for a specific member or range of members. I'll create a rule to translate the travel expense account for the United Kingdom entity using the exchange rate from the last period of the prior year. I'll use year-to-date for the translation method and ending for the rate account. Click Advanced to select the scenario, year, and period from which to retrieve the exchange rates. You can select member names or use a keyword. I'll select the prior year keyword for year and the last period keyword for period. Next, I'll define the scope for the rule. I want to apply this rule to all Level 0 members of the Travel Expenses Parent account for the actual scenario and the United Kingdom entity for all years. You can optionally click Redirect Members to post the translated values to a different member. I don't need to redirect values in this rule, so I'll click Remove Redirection. You can update the same account using multiple rules. Use the Processing options to determine how the rule results accumulate in the account. The results from a rule can replace the value from the previous rule, be added to it, or be subtracted from it. This enables you to accumulate values and to perform calculations. Accounts are always first translated using the default translation settings, even if a translation rule exists for an account. If translation rules exist for an account and there is no redirection, the value from the first rule overwrites the value that resulted from the default translation setting, regardless of the processing option selected. If there are additional translation rules for the same account, the account value is updated using the processing option selected for the rule. I'm finished defining this rule, so I'll click Save and Close. To activate the rule, I must deploy it. You do not need to refresh the database after deploying rules. Now, I'll run a translation for travel expenses for the United Kingdom to verify my translation rule results. Recall that the default translation method is set to use the periodic translation method and the average rate for flow accounts. Our rule is set to override the default and use the ending exchange rate from the last period of the prior year. The February 2024 average exchange rate for British pounds to US dollars is 2. The ending exchange rate for the last period of the prior year is 3. Now I'll translate travel expenses for the UK for February. The system applies the translation rule to the travel expenses parent and its level 0 descendants, using the last period of the prior year ending rate of 3, rather than the current period average rate of 2. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.